never defeat me!
Hello everyone and welcome back for another episode of Diablo 3. In the last episode, we ran through Act 1, Act 2, and Act 4. We're pushing on with more bounties. We're in Act 5, of course. And we're going to start with the Cursed Shrines. I had a question off camera as to whether certain classes are more prone to find certain set items. And I think, yes, that's true. I mean, obviously, you're going to find ones that are geared to your specific class. There are, I think it's a 10% chance you find something that's out of class. So I get particularly unlucky. This season, I've been finding a bunch of Witch Doctor items. But in addition to that, every season, I notice that there are some items where they've massively improved the drop rate. So whether it's they're building for specific things for people to try, or whether it's just, you know, the random number generator isn't actually as random as anyone thinks. You'll find one season everyone's getting the Saffron Wrap and improving overpower, or another season everyone's getting Nagel Ring and exploding things. In my experience anyway, I mean, it's been 5 seasons and I have noticed certain patterns when I've been playing with certain character classes. And it's not always based around the set that they're doing with Hadrix's set. I mean, Hadrix's Gift is a pretty new concept in the grand scheme of things. Right, let's get into the Bound Keep and round to the shrines. I do like being able to just whirl through stuff, even if it tries to rubber band me back like that. Damn cheaty game. One to go. There we go. Now we just need to mop up. Stab, stab, stab. Paragon 184. Who knows, we might hit Paragon 200 tonight. Might. I mean, there's always a chance. We've gained 9 levels so far with 3 acts of bounties, so it's possible. Let's go to kill Amash the Grizzly. We'll put that Paragon point in. Just over here. Alright. 150 mobs to kill as well, so we will take the time to kill things properly on the way. Not that we've got particularly far to go, of course, but it's important to get the methodology in, if nothing else. Okay, 25 down, 125 to go. Ooh, Marquis Topaz. Yoink. Nice big group to cleave together. And here's another small pack. So we're about a third of the way there at the moment. Let's try and lead a nice group together. Explosions aside. Run away from me, come back. Right, gotta keep our shouts up as well. That looks like it's a special event thing, so we could potentially get some good mob killing going. I'm honestly surprised that there aren't more of these boggarts. And we're not even halfway at the moment. I was expecting a hell of a lot more. If this was a rift, I would be thoroughly disappointed. There's a bunch. Alright. 82 down. Hey, there's 5 in here. At least I think it's 5. It looked like 5. Tusk Bogun, you're gonna die. Let's just refresh our shouts again. Right, we are 2/3 of the way there. Worst time to come running towards me. He didn't actually get hit by the facial explosion, but if he hadn't died by the thorns, then he would have died by that. It'd be nice if thorns damage did like a slightly different color so you can specifically identify it compared to everything else that's going on. Or if there was a combat log that you could bring up that shows every hit that was going on. Just for curiosity's sake, if nothing else. Alright, we only need 8 more. 8 more! There's a couple. Very nice of that trap helping us along. That will do. That will do quite happily. Let's grab this, and we're gonna move on to... let's kill Urziel. Captain Flamer is always a little bit dangerous, but we should be fine. Once we find him, I mean, he's actually miles away. Let's try and move quickly through the town. No, I said go this way. Don't bounce back towards them. Of course, saying go quickly. If I get distracted by, like, a puppy, then... it'll happen. And I desperately want that full reflection. There we go. Right. Back on mission. Still not even halfway there yet. Only really stopping to kill the packs that are nicely grouped together when we've got a big number training behind us. Kaboom! Massive explosion time. Alright, we can start heading up and around now, I think. Corpses everywhere. Corpses everywhere, which just means more things to kill. While I'm passing, I may as well see what's in the chest. Nope, nothing. It would have been cool if there was something nice for us, but alas, we are not that lucky. Alright, we are getting closer. Still a long way to go, though. Not down this way. Round to the left. Yeah. And then back a little bit. And then we're actually on the right street, I think. That took us an exceptionally long time to make our way across to. Damn wallers. Let's get them killed before we go in. Ooh, okay. Might have a quick look at that as well. Looks like it might be gold wrap, hard to tell. What is this belt? Eh, it's a vigilante belt. It's not particularly special, not particularly bad either. Okay, we are going to gain a level from this, or we're going to die. I'm hoping for the former rather than the latter. Soon. Lots of stabbing, lots of stabbing. Did he just cannon one of my tiny terrorists? I think he did. Ha, I can attack you as well. I mean, pyong pyong. Long range attacks. Alright, now that you're actually in place, let's obviously watch out for... Ah! Already? Alright, well, I guess we'll pop Wrath of the Berserker then. If you're going super flamey. No. No, thank you. That was nasty. Do not like his flamethrower one bit. His cannon I don't mind. Cannon is like totally dodgeable. If he decides that he's doing all the flamey stuff. Look how quickly he turns around as well. I mean, that is all dangerous as hell. Alright, let's get in on him. Right, I'll grab this. Come on, I need you a bit more centrally to fight properly. Not because I'm scared, but just to be sensible, because that flamethrower is always going to be dangerous. Jesus! That'd be a solid no, mate. Come on, tiny terrorist, get in there and... Very, very nearly got him. Are we going to explode? Ooh, a little bit of rubber banding there as well. Oh, Jesus. All right. Popped an ignore pain and used the healing fountain. But that flamethrower is nasty, nasty, nasty. Very dangerous. Alright, well, we may as well loot the room, and then we'll head on to the plague tunnels. Our biggest problem is not being able to move away from him fast enough when that happens, because even when we're whirling, he'll blast it out, and we'll get hit 4 or 5 times in very quick succession. Not cool, not cool. Let's do Grey Hallowland, actually. It's still got... like 15 seconds left before we get our extra death back, but it'll probably be that before we find anything dangerous here. So we've got to find a forest prayer and disturb, I think. Sound simple enough. I wonder if it's down this way or if it's still up in the other area. Hopefully we won't have to head back, but if we do, we can always just dive it this way. Good. Let's get our shouts done. Kill the things that are outside first. Or Wrath of the Berserker on as well. Crippler of Princes, eh? Cripple you. Plague shielding reflects damage. Let's loot this and then we can head on in. Ooh, actually we'll... Ooh, braces, alright. Let's have a look at those. They're boring braces. We'll ID them when we get back. To be fair, if I was praying in a forest and then all these hunter bats started flying down, I'd be quite disturbed as well. then complete. All right. That went a fair bit faster than I was expecting. We'll just make sure that these are all dead out here, and then we'll move on to the next bounty, which is, of course, the plague tunnels. Put that Paragon point in as well. There we go. Apparently, we're heading down miles away. Oh my god, so far away. Alright, it's marathon time. And I don't mean the old chocolate bar. Is it even this way? I don't think it's even this way. I think it's going to be down that one. Back we go. Yeah, you can kill yourselves on me if you like, but it's not going to do you any favors. It might do me a favor or two, but... I will stop and kill this yellow, though. Because that's pretty much everything that we do. We go to do bounty, we get distracted by yellow and blue packs, we stop, we kill them, and we actually move on to do the bounty. Get those nice health globes, get some healing on. I hope it's this way rather than down the other one. It's all heading in roughly the right direction. But with West March being such a wonderful maze of streets, it's always a gamble as to whether you're going in the right direction. Nope. Do love it when the facial explosions go off and actually smack into things. Like, accidentally, rather than you being in big fight and hoping it's going to happen, because that's awesome as well. But... Well, seeing as we're here... I don't think so. My face says no. All of the explosions. All of the explosions happening. Oh, Vowel. Order of the Deathlight. Oh, that's pretty cool. Took a hell of a lot of damage when she attacked me there. 706 million health, and it took a big old chunk off. Alright, let's just head on down. Ignore that dude. So, now we need to find level 2, which is actually pretty close. As long as it's not a massive maze to get around there, it should be alright. And we'll grab that. Make sure our shouts are nice and refreshed as well, and we will push on round. Ooh, I heard a goblin. I see the goblin. Alright, let's focus on the goblin then for the moment. Other things happen to die at the same time, then, you know, that's just convenient for us. You got nowhere to go, mate. Nowhere to go. Another death breath. And we're full of stuff. Alright, let's head back and drop this stuff off quickly. Hey, Drake. Let's ID these. Grand Braces of Sesheron. That's a pretty nice thing. I'm not that fussed by it. We're going to put it in the cube, of course. Let's salvage up the Vigilante Belt because that serves us no purpose whatsoever other than just being a death's breath. I can go down there and we'll drop off the rest of these. Alright, back into the plague tunnels. Finish looting the area, and on we go. Right, everyone has to die in here. starting with three by the door, but followed up by you. Another goblin, by the sounds of it. That will be quite fortunate. Let's build up some fury on these guys. It's an odious collector. Put Wrath of the Berserker on just to help with the killing. Unsurprisingly, went down pretty quickly. Let's loot all of these, and then we'll actually go after you, nightmarish crawler thing. Let's loot all of this stuff. Okay, there's still more for us to kill, so we will try and move around nice and logically. We'll do a leper wall hug until they start showing up on the map. Let's whirl the hell out of that. Definitely not a good plan for a place to be. Alright, 9 mobs left. May as well loot everything while we're passing. Let's put this paragon point in, actually. And then we'll head on to the next little section over here. Still 2 mobs to find. Must be in the final bit. Let's go have a look. There they are. Back to town. Okay, give me all the good stuff. More plans, Bourne's Command, and those will be Death's Embrace. Let's have a look at those. Teach Bourne's Command. Oh, sorry, Death's Bargain, not Death's Embrace. I think I've already got a set in here. Let's have a look. Yeah, I do. Although these ones are better. So let's put that in there. And we will salvage up these ones instead. Prepare all our kit, and we're ready for the final act of bounties. Okay, we are heading on to Act 3, as you'd expect. We'll do Ganta the Trickster first. He was actually back in the Skycrown battlements. Hey, how's it going? Well, it's a bit ugly, you know, made of bones and goo and stuff. Actually, that's kind of like people. Fourteen mobs down. By the time we find the one we're actually supposed to be killing, we should have easily hit the right number. Bring these two closer. Alright, we're 1/5 of the way. Oh, actually, he's a lot closer. Still, there is plenty of mobs on this area. Put Wrath of the Berserker on while we whirl through these quickly. One shot, one kill. Kablang. Kablang is a technical term, by the way. It's the sound that the braces I'm wearing make when they go off. Right, 75, 81. Let's grab all of these. Get another book. I'm surprised there's still books to read this season. We've done a lot of reading so far. Let's get right up next to this one. Hop and ignore pain just to help us face tank him for a little bit. Right, 11 mobs left to find. That's probably just going to be a big hack of Fallen. Yeah, these will do. Now, we don't have an ignore pain on cooldown at the moment, so we're going to be a little bit careful. But I do want to kill these guys. Mostly careful because of the fire chains, of course. Right, they are dead. Let's head on to... Yeah, let's kill Gorm, actually. Why not? Oh, yeah. Maximus, stand in the way. Thank you. Boom! Boom. Oh, Sangreenu Vambrace is just triggering several times along with Deathwatch Mantle. Oh! Alright. Let's go after the Gelatinous Sire. We do obviously have the Wrath of the Berserker ready. Man, this is going to be difficult to get all of them. Right, Wrath of the Berserker time, I think. Oh, did he get away? I think he got away. But that is pretty good for chasing down as many as I did. I'm pretty happy with that. And we're not even really geared for stuff that doesn't attack us. We got a unique ring out of that. Let's have a quick look at what that is. Justice Lantern. Well, we've already got one of those, so that's a Forgotten Soul. Let's see if we can't make quick progress towards the larder. Exploding our way through stuff will obviously help. Okay. Somehow I don't think we're going to hit Paragon 200 with this set of bounties, but we're going to get close. Maybe 190 something. Right, Gorm. Let's have a chat about personal hygiene. I don't want to ignore pain and just ultra face tank him, but let's see how we go. Yeah, ignore pain. And I will just need to be a bit careful over my fury levels and life levels. We're about to lose Wrath of the Berserker as well. Alright, let's back out for a moment. Just for a bit, we'll do some regenning around the edge. I can still attack him from here, actually. Okay, calm down. What's in the Diabolic Horde? Lots of gems, and yeah, that's basically it. Paragon Point goes in, and we are moving on to clear Kryder's outpost. We're going to kill everything inside it. Got murder on the brain. I think that's what it comes down to. So far to go. All the way out into the field. Hello. Let's get you guys killed, seeing as you're all nicely clustered together. Good, good, good. Right. Everyone in here dies. And more books. I can't pick up any. Oh, I guess we're heading back to town, actually. We are full of junk. Not a surprise after the goblins that we ran into. So, salvage those up. We'll salvage the Justice Lantern up as well. And these can all get dropped off nicely. Got a good stack. I should probably start moving some gems up the rankings now. That will certainly help with our damage outputs, both for this character and our other character. Maybe I'll do that as part of Monday Night Gaming, I don't know. Don't make me run away. Although with my crab control reduction, it does reduce the amount I end up running away, but let's pop an ignore pain because we're in the middle of those orbital things. There we go. Get facial explosions going on those. Right, let's heal up. There's 7 mobs left. Oh, and another goblin. It's just a regular treasure goblin. Cute little thing. Get some full-on murder going on him. There we go. Grab all the delicious things. Right, there's 4 mobs left. And that looks like that might be them. Okay, on to kill Garganug. Garganug. That's a stupid name, even for a demon. Right. 14 of the 100 mobs that we need to kill are taken care of. Let's push on through these things. Try and build up some fury and then we'll go whirling all through the next set. Come on, kill yourselves on me. Doesn't take much. There we go. Fleeting Shrine, good. That'll help us move around a fair bit between the areas. I do like these demonic hellbearers. They're a good way of building up your numbers without too much hassle. Not enough that I'm just going to stand there and let them churn out. There we go, saved you. Yeah, you're actually standing next to the guy that his face explodes. That's who you got rescued by. The dude is basically a demon. And another goblin. Oh, we are getting lucky today. That one's a gem one. Let's head up to get him because I do like extra gems. Yeah, you can't run away from me. I got a fleeting shrine on. Although I am gonna... I thought I was gonna explode. Apparently I was just gonna stand there looking like a dumbass. Oh, Alright, let's grab these. Ignore the wallers for the moment. I want to get all my gems, and then we'll come back and kill them. Okay. Now, back to the mission. Waller teleports and knock back Molten. Let's pop and ignore pain, and we'll just get the hell out of that. Waller's nasty in close quarters. Yeah, I'm more Molten than you are. When I explode, things don't come back from it. Oh, Garganog is still a long ways away. Okay. Let's push on forwards. Reflection. Let's grab that. Ah, arcane enchanted. Frozen nightmarish reflects damage and arcane enchanted. That's a horrible combination. It's all the annoying things that make you leave an area. It's like massive area denial. Big ass pack. Let's get right in the middle of this. And then we'll get back on mission. Good job. Exploding when everything is already moved out of the area. This guy must be right at the very, very end. Not that I mind. I mean, you know, killing everything on the way to him is still fun, but... it's a surprise. King of the Golgors. Wow. He nearly killed himself in one go, but he actually survived. He survived the Vambraces going off. It's pretty impressive for the amount of health he must have had. Okay, final one is the Three Guardians. Let's go across and do that. So, the Kazra Arena, that's somewhere at the back from what I remember. Yeah, we've got all those books. We got our learning on for the barbarians. We know we've got barbarian smarts. That's Paragon 119. Which I will put in a moment. I just want to get my way through to the arena. Right, let's go out this way. Don't mind me, guys. You know, we're just here to admire the drum. That's all we're doing. Right, let's put this Paragon point in, and then we will kill the Guardians. Talos' warriors are down. Next up, Mordals. Stab. And Korbal. Chief Shaman. Chief Dead Shaman, at least. Alright, time for Wrath of the Berserker. Let's get everyone murdered. Talos Immortal already down, Korbal's gone, and there we go. Let's head back to Tyriel. Alright. What have we got in the bags? A another amulet. Well, we've seen this one before. That'll be overwhelming desire. Which it is. Okay, let's very quickly talk to Ghidala about some rings, because I've got enough blood shards for us to try for 6 of them. What a steal. All disappointing. All very much disappointing. I think we'll salvage up our bits and bobs, and then that's a good point for us to call that episode there. Thank you very much for watching. I do hope that you've enjoyed this run through and another bounty set. We are, of course, making progress through the Paragon levels and getting more and more equipment as we go. We haven't found anything extra to fill out our build, but hopefully soon we'll find another couple of nice pieces. But I'm going to finish it there. So thank you very much for watching, and join me again next time for more Diablo 3. I'll see you soon.